In this video, we are going to make sure that our enemy can die in all directions. Earlier, we already added some functionality for the enemy to die, but we actually broke that again when we added the different states for him. As you can see, if I kill him, this warning here, or yeah, this warning pops up and says parameter die doesn't exist. So we'll have to make this work again so that we can actually kill him in all directions. So first of all, we need to select the animator and select our enemy. And what we have to do is to create a new layer, and the layer is going to be a death layer. So click little plus here and write death layer. And this layer is going to handle everything when the enemy dies. So first of all, we can select idle layer and select the idles and copy it by pressing Ctrl C, going to the death layer and pasting it by pressing Ctrl V. The next thing we have to do is to rename this. It shouldn't be named idles inside the death layer, so select it and rename it to deaths. And then we have to double click on the green, orange deaths, and replace all these animations, because right now he's just idling when he's supposed to die. So to do that, we have to select the skeleton, and we need to create all the animations for deaths. We already have death down, because that's what we tested with earlier. So we need to select death left and select all of them, drag them into the scene and select animations and go in here and rename this one to die left and select death right and select all of them, drag them in, select assets, animations, anyone, and die right. And then we have the up one as the last one, select them in here, animations, anyone, die underscore up. There we go. So select all these three, delete them, go to the animations folder and select all the new controllers and delete them as well. So now we can select our enemy, go into idles. Oops, sorry. Why is it named idle still? There we go. Okay, I had the wrong layer. Sorry, I confused myself. So select the death layer, of course. Enemy, death layer, deaths, blend tree, and replace all these with the die animations from the enemy. Remember to use the animations for the enemy. So die down, and die right, and die up, and die left. So now everything is almost set here. The problem is that if I play it now, you'll see if I select the enemy, it actually plays the death animation right away. And we don't want that. We don't want it to play the death animation before he's dead. So we need to set up a new state here called alive. And when the alive state, it should always be the what's called default state. So the alive state is the default state. And now we need to make a transition from alive to death. So make a transition here. And go to parameters and create a trigger called die. This trigger will make sure that he goes from alive to death whenever he dies. So select this transition, make sure it hasn't got any exit time and that the transition duration is zero, and then select die as a condition here. So when he dies, it goes from alive to death. So if we play it now, nothing is going to happen, but the difference is going to be that it's not going to complain about that parameter not existing, because as you can see, I have the enemy selected, it's alive, and when he dies, it goes down to death. So that's exactly what we want. But we can't see it right now, and the reason that we can't see it is because the death layer, the weight here, is actually zero, because something is resetting it. As you can see, I can't even use the mouse here to reset it to one. So we need to write some code to make sure it switches from the idle layer to the death layer, or whatever layer he's in, to the death layer when he dies. So to do that, we need to open up the character script. So find your character script inside scripts and character. And in here, we need to make sure that we can switch layers. So first of all, we need to know if the enemy is alive. The easiest way to do that is to make a public bool called isAlive. This property here is going to return if the enemy is alive or not. So it's going to return current something called health. Let's see here, my health. That return sets that character my health dot my current value less than zero, or larger than zero, sorry. What's it called? Is it health stat? Let me see, health stat. Yeah, that should work, and then return it. And there we go. So I think this should work. So is alive is going to return true if the health current value is larger than zero, which means he's alive, and it's going to return false if it's less than zero, which means he's dead. Okay, so we have to go to the handle layers here. So if is alive, so if we are alive, all the code here is okay to execute, right? We're just going to encapsulate the code that was already there in an if statement called if is alive. So if he's alive, we can walk, we can attack, and we can idle. But if he's dead, then we're not going to do any of these. We're going to say else activate layer death layer. So now we're going to activate our death layer when he dies. And what checks if we are dead? Well, this one does. The take damage function checks if we are dead. If we are that, then we set the trigger to die. So try to save this and see what happens when you play it now. Because now it should actually switch his animation to a dead animation. So the down one should work as expected. He should die and just lay there on the ground. As you can see here. And he's dead. But there's a problem. If I walk close to him, he will start following me. Another thing that's a problem is the fact that he is going to loop some of the animations. As you can see, if I outrun him, if I can manage to do that there, and I attack him and kill him, then you'll see that the up attack or up idle animation or death animation, sorry, is going to loop. As you can see, he keeps looping when he follows me. And that's not what we want. So first of all, select your animations, anime one, select all the die animations and make sure that this loop time tick up here is actually removed. There we go. So all the die animations should have loop time removed. With that done, we can go back. And now we need to make sure he can't move or anything when he's dead. So first of all, we need to go to the move function, because this one is called from up here in fixed update. And I can say if is alive. So if I'm alive, I'm able to move. What else? Handle layers. Well, we also check that here. But if we open up the enemy and go to the override of the update somewhere there, we're checking if we can attack and everything. And we're also doing that regardless of if he's dead or alive. So right here, we say if is alive as well and put all the code in here. And then we also stop the base update from running, which is also handle layers. So we have a little double checking, but that's okay. So if he's alive, then we can do all everything. We can attack, we can move. If he's not alive, well, then we make sure that we can't move. So I think that's it for now. Let's try and save this and see. He should still be moving though, even though he's dead. Let's try here. So if I kill this one, he'll just be moving slower though. Now he's dead, and he's not even playing the animation anymore. So let's see what we did. So I think the reason that this doesn't work is the fact that we are changing into the death layer right here in handle layers, and handle layer is not going to be called when he's dead. So to make sure that, because we have this out here, let's see, I can actually go, oh, find all references, sorry, there. So we are handling layers here, but our player, or sorry, our enemy here, is making sure that doesn't happen. So we can do different things. We can move the base update out here. So update is going to be called regardless of if he's alive or not. So let's try to do that instead. So go to enemy, go to update, and make sure the base update is outside if alive. Let's try again. Sorry about the confusion. Let's try one more time. So select him and we attack him. And he should go into death animation when he dies. And he does. Okay. So when I get close to him, nothing is wrong. He doesn't follow me. But there is one problem. It's, as you can see right here, our enemy doesn't move when he's dead if we go towards him when he's dead. But if I kill him while he's moving, then he's actually going to keep moving in that direction he was moving in when he got killed. So you can see here, he has one hit left. So if I go close to him and kill him, you'll see that he dies and then he follows that path he had before. So to fix that, we will have to go to the character script. And inside the character script, we will have to set our direction equal to vector2.0 just for good measure. And then we have to say my rigid body dot velocity equals direction. So now we are setting our direction to vector2.0, so nothing happens if we get back to a loop where we can move. And then we make sure that our velocity is 0 by setting it equal to direction. So if I save that and jump into Unity and try to kill him one more time, then you'll see that he's actually not going to move anymore. See here, he has 5 health. And there we go. So now he died and he stops moving right there. So that's how you can kill the enemy, and this should work in all directions as well. You can just test it if you want to. So that's what I want to show in this video. In the next video, I will add the functionality for colliding with the water so that the player can't just walk over it like this. So we will add some colliders to it so that it will actually work like real water, like the trees does right here when we try to walk into them. So thank you very much for watching.
Thanks for watching my video. Please remember that InScope Studios is a community founded page, so please consider clicking the support link on the screen to see how you can support me and get something back in return.